In this video, I'm going to show you how to import MOGRTs inside Premiere Pro. The first thing to do is change your workspace from editing to captions and graphics. This will make the essential graphics panel visible to the right side. If you don't see this, go up to Window, Essential Graphics. To import a MOGRT, you'll see this button in the bottom right. Click it and a file explorer will appear. Navigate to your MOGRT, click on it, and then click Open. You'll then see that our MOGRT is loaded inside the panel. Now this is great just for one MOGRT, but what if you have a pack, like several MOGRTs? There's another way that you can actually import them. To do that, you'll navigate to the hamburger menu inside the Essential Graphics panel. Then click on Manage Additional Folders. This allows you to direct Premiere Pro to a folder. So click the Add button, and then navigate to a folder where you have several MOGRTs. For example here, I have my free animated MOGRTs pack that is available if you do want to download it in the video description below. It's a free animated elements pack, so a lot of, you know, boxes, swirlies, pops and stuff. But once you navigate to that folder, click Select Folder. This will add it to the Manage Additional Folders section, and then you'll want to click OK. This will import all the MOGRTs in here. So you can see we have the swirlies pop up here, as well as the lines, the different boxes and bursts that come in the pack. Okay, so now that we have them imported, how do we add them to our Premiere Pro timeline? Well, there's a few different ways you can go about it. For example here, I want to add this title graphic before the clip in my timeline. To do that, click on the MOGRT in the Essential Graphics panel, click and drag while holding Command down on your keyboard, and you'll notice that you have some arrows pointed to the right side. This will essentially add it from that point and move all the clips to the right. So when we click and drag to the far left and then release, it'll add that graphic in while pushing the clip to the far right. So it doesn't interfere with the clip at all. It just shifts it over. You can also add MOGRTs just over your footage. To do that, just click and drag your MOGRT over your footage. And this will just be added directly over your footage here. So how do you edit these MOGRTs? Well, there's essentially a separate tab inside Essential Graphics where you can actually edit them. To do that, click on a MOGRT, and then you'll notice that you'll be redirected to the Edit tab. There's the Browse tab and the Edit tab. This is where you can change the parameters of the MOGRT. So for example, this burst, we can realign it to a different part of the screen by changing the position of it. We can change the color of the burst to a different color. And any of the other elements that you added to your MOGRT pack or that comes with it, you can adjust it here in the Essential Graphics panel. You can see we have glow options and different things that we can adjust. Same goes for our title graphic. Here though, you'll notice that there's an image section. So you can actually change out the image here by just clicking on the hamburger menu and going to Replace from Finder. I'm gonna navigate to my new headshot and click Open. Then you'll notice it will replace, and then we can just scale this up and then reposition it accordingly. You have other options such as text controls, and like I said, all of these are built out when you actually go to export a After Effects template, or they're already built into the MOGRT when you download it from a stock website. Next, I want to go over some organizational tips when it comes to working with MOGRTs inside Premiere Pro. If you work with several MOGRTs, you might want to use the text panel to edit your text. For example, if we click on this MOGRT here and bring up our text panel by going up to Window Text, you'll see by default it's on Captions and Transcript, but there's actually a Graphics section. And in here you can actually, you know, change the text. And if you're looking for someone's name, you can type in the search bar the person's name and actually go and find and replace that text. So the text panel can be quite helpful if you work with several MOGRTs. The other thing that you can do is actually save your favorites. In the Essential Graphics panel, when we go back to Browse, you'll notice that there's these star icons next to the MOGRTs. You can click these to actually favorite and save your favorite MOGRTs. So if we start this one, we can go up to the star icon in the top right, and now we can see our favorited MOGRTs that we saved that we want to reuse in future projects. So that's how to work with MOGRTs inside Premiere Pro. If you want to see some free MOGRTs that you can download, I do recommend this one website. If you want to check it out, I'll link that video right up there. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.